friends, welcome back to my channel. So I was super inspired by my tiny house which I've recently built and how much it looks like a caravan that I decided I actually wanted to build a caravan here in Bloxburg, because when I was really tiny my family would always go on caravanning holidays. We'd go caravanning in the south of France and at seaside resorts in the UK, like Filey is my favourite seaside place in the UK, just to let you guys know. But yeah, we'd stay in these kind of caravans like this. I don't know if these kind of caravans exist outside of Europe. Like whenever I imagine like American caravans, I just picture like RVs and like camper vans and kind of things. I don't know if you have these kind of like rectangular ones that we have, but these are like a stationary caravan, so you can like move them around. They have wheels and everything, but most of the time you kind of leave them in one place and then, you know, you move them every now and then. But they're usually on like caravan sites that you can go and stay at, and they're just like quite popular places to go stay because, you know, they're quite affordable and all that stuff. But this one behind me, I kind of imagine, is at like a seaside resort, just because of the colors, like the blue and the white. I think it looks really like oceany, and I've just put some decoration around them just to kind of, you know, set the scene. We've got some trees and things, and then outside the caravan I've just got these kind of sun beds that you can, you know, lay on and catch some rays. And then this kind of area here is like the decking, because whenever I stayed at a caravan, they have kind of like a decking area outside. So I've just used like this little table to kind of create a decking kind of bit. Usually like on caravans, you'd have like steps up to them and the caravans are kind of like propped up a bit, but that's kind of hard to do in Bloxburg. So that's one of the reasons kind of I want them to add like door steps and stuff, and maybe like actually be able to put stuff up a bit. Like imagine if you could like build it just like a bit higher and have like a gap underneath. How cool would that be for like vehicles and stuff? Anyway, let's head inside the caravan. So coming inside, this is like the main living space. Over here we have the kitchen area, and I really like this little kitchen. I fit so much in it. So we just got like a mini fridge. I decided to use a mini fridge rather than the big fridge, because the big fridges take up so much space. Something I'd love to see in a Bloxburg update that I missed off the video I did before is like a countertop fridge, you know, like the ones that kind of go inside the counter. I have one of those in real life, so you'd like open the door and the fridge is inside. Like, I think that'd save so much space and it just looks super cute. But yeah, we've got the little mini fridge up here, and then we've got sink, and then like of course washing up sponge and washing up liquid that I've literally been adding in every build. But I like this little kitchen. I feel like I fit so much in here. And next to the kitchen we just have a kind of little dining table area where you can sit and, you know, eat your dinner. Because whenever I used to go caravanning when I was little, it would always rain, like no matter what. If we're in the south of France, which is super warm in the summer, it'd still rain. But I do kind of like being inside a caravan when it's raining. It's such like a relaxing sound. But yeah, I really like how this has turned out. This is a little dining table. I guess you could like sit here and play board games and things. Like, I feel like playing board games is such like a caravan thing to do. Anyway, over this side we have like the little sitting area. So whenever I picture a caravan, I imagine like a big L-shaped sofa, which I've kind of tried to replicate. I stuck two of these sofas together, which I did not know that you could literally put them together and be able to do like this kind of thing. Like, how cute does this look? So you can like sit on the sofa here, and yeah, I did kind of want it to be bigger and kind of make it come up here, but it wasn't possible. But I do like how it looks, and I've just got some decoration thrown about. So we've just got like some tables behind here that I put some lights and plants and stuff on. We've got a nice big decorative mirror, and then over here is the little TV stand, so you know, you can sit and watch some TV on rainy days in your caravan. We'll just turn that off and head into this room here. So this room is kind of like the parents' bedroom. So when I used to go caravanning when I was little, this would be like where my parents would sleep. So I've just got a nice big double bed in here. We've got some little bedside tables that I put some lights on, and then this is just like a little desk slash like dressing table. So I've just got some like hair stuff and a mirror and things, and nice big mirror, picture of the ocean, because like I said, I kind of picture this being at a seaside, so that's very cute. And then let's head over to this side. So on this side is like the kids' bedroom. So this would be where me and my brother would have slept when we were little. So we have like a bed each, and I've gone like, I put like so many patterns in this caravan, because like when I picture a caravan, like I imagine them having like loads of different patterns. Like the ones I stayed in were definitely not this stylish. Like they had like really ugly patterns on the bedding and stuff, and on the curtains, and it was all kind of mismatched. So this is kind of like a stylish version of the one I slept in. But yeah, this is the kids' bedroom. I really like it. So we've got a bed each, we've got a little kind of bedside table with a light on, and I put this cute little kitty cat on it. And then we've got some storage above here. So I've been using these cabinets again, like I do in the tiny house, for like wardrobes. They just kind of, you know, give you more space to put things underneath when you use them. And I kind of like how they look. I know they're kitchen cabinets, but I like it, you know, so we're rolling with it. And then this tiny little room next door is the bathroom for the caravan. So in here, it's just like your basic little bathroom. We've just got the mirror, we've got the toilet. Oops, I'm not enjoying this new Zoom, guys, but we have the toilet, and then I've just got like a shower and a sink and everything. And yeah, it's just like everything you'd need in a cute little bathroom. I'm really happy with how this turned out, guys. I absolutely love this build, especially the outside of the caravan. I think looks so like realistic to the caravans I'm talking about. So if any of you have like stayed in these kind of caravans, you know that this like just looks like one of those caravans. I'm so happy with it. I've added like wheels. They're a bit big, but they, you know, they kind of give the point. And then around here, I've actually, which I thought was quite creative, I've added like a registration plate with one of these like long pictures. It's a bit big, but you know, it's a cute little detail. So anyway, guys, that is it for the tour of the caravan. As always, the speed build for this caravan will be coming up in just a few moments, so stick around if you want to watch that. If not, that's totally fine. But please do like and subscribe if you did enjoy this video. Leave any comments down below with any future ideas for videos that you would love to see. I love hearing your guys' ideas. And thank you for watching, guys. Bye. Mwah. huge thank you as always for those of you who stuck around to the end of the video, guys. Please do like and subscribe if you did enjoy this video, and comment down below with any future ideas for videos. I love hearing your guys' ideas, and a big thank you, guys. Bye.